Welcome to RSET Online Lecture Series on the subject CS309 Graph Theory and Combinatorics for the branch Computer Science and Engineering of Semester 5. Myself, Bindu VA, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Rajagiri School of Engineering and Technology. In this lecture, I am discussing on the topics of Module 2, Part 1 of this lecture. First, we can define an Euler graph. An Euler graph is defined as if some closed work in a graph contains all the edges of the graph, then the work is called an Euler line and the graph is called an Euler graph. The drawings shown in the figure is called Muhammad's scimitars and is believed to have come from the Arabs. The second figure is the Star of David. Both pictures we can draw in one continuous line without retracing and without lifting the pen from the paper. We can show how we can start from a vertex and ending at the same vertex, passing through all the edges exactly once and return to that same vertex where we started. Here it is an Euler graph. Begin and end vertices are the same. A theorem related to Euler graph. A given connected graph G is an Euler graph if and only if all the vertices of G are of even degree. The proof is, first assume that G is an Euler graph. And we have to prove that the degree of each vertex in the graph is even. Since G is Euler, it contains an Euler line which represents a closed work. If we trace this work, we see that for every line, the work meets a vertex V and goes through two new edges incident on V and exit from V. This is true not only of all intermediate vertices of the work but also of the terminal vertex. See the figure. If we entering into V, we can exit from V since the degree of that vertex is even. Since we exited and entered the terminal vertex at the beginning and end of the work respectively, thus, if G is an Euler graph, the degree of each vertex is even. Next, the converse part. Given all vertices are of even degree, we have to prove that G is an Euler graph. Given all vertices are even degree, we construct a work starting at an arbitrary vertex V and going through the edges of G such that no edges traced more than once and continue tracing as far as possible. Since every vertex is of even degree, we can exit from every vertex we enter. The tracing cannot stop at any vertex but at V. And since V is also of even degree, we shall eventually reach at V when the tracing comes to an end. If this closed work H we just traced includes all the edges of G, G is an Euler graph. If not, we remove from G all the edges in H and obtain a subgraph H dash of G formed by the remaining edges. This will be evident in the next slide how we can remove the traced edge to get the subgraph H dash. See the figure. If we are starting from V through the red lines, we can come back to V through the red lines. Since both G and H have all the vertices of even degree, the degree of the vertices of H dash are also even. If we are removing the red lines like this, H dash must touch H at least at one vertex A because G is connected. Starting from A, we can again construct a new work in the graph H dash. Since all the vertices of h dash are of even degree, this walk in h dash must terminate at the vertex A. But this walk in h dash can be combined with h to form a new walk, which start and end at the vertex V, as shown in the figure, and has more edges than h. This process can be repeated until we obtain a closed walk that traverses all the edges of G. Thus, G is an Euler graph. And with this theorem, we are getting the solution to the Königsbridge problem. The problem can be represented by a graph. The four land areas given by A, B, C and D. This problem we were discussing module 1. The two islands and banks of the river are connected by the 7 bridges. The bridges are denoted by the edges. The land areas by the vertices A, B, C and D. From the figure it is clear that the degree of each vertex, degree of A equal to 5, degree of C equal to 3, degree of B is equal to 3 and degree of D is equal to 3. And degree of all the vertices are not even, therefore we cannot find an Euler walk in this problem. Therefore, Euler proved that the solution for this problem does not exist because not all its vertices are of even. Hence, it is not an Euler graph. Thus, it is not possible to walk over each of the 7 bridges exactly once and return to the starting point. With this, we conclude end of part 1. Thank you.